Another useful panel output is to create skeleton panels. Skeleton panels just contain the bare minimum of information needed to make the panel, and this information can either be used to make the panel manually, or it can be used for checking panels which have been produced on other, more automated methods. Here, I'll select the panels, specify a skeleton panel drawing, output the panels, and on each edge, I have a length specification and a dip. A length and a dip. I'll go back a stage in Rhino so that we can see the original panels, and the meaning of the dip is the distance from the center of that line over to the curve. This can either be used for checking the panel once it's been produced, or that a panel can approximately be created by measuring a distance on the floor of this length, and then with a flexible ruler, something like a piece of white plastic pipe, you can bend the pipe into this curve, moving it in the amount that's specified in the dip. And in that way, large panels can be created without expensive automated cutting equipment.